Okay students, now you are most welcome to the next video lecture. The topic is compound belonging to the same chapter, is matter around us pure? Before we discuss the compound in details, let us recapitulate all this thing that we have already gone through previously in this chapter on elements. You know, element is a pure substance. It is made up of one kind of atom, already we have discussed. And this element is divided into three parts. One is metal, second one is non-metal, third one is metallic. And all we have discussed with suitable example. Sorry. Now, we move on to another pure substance, that is compound. A compound is a pure substance which is made up of two or more different elements in their fixed ratio. We have a number of compounds in nature. They are formed chemically or by the combination of different elements in their fixed ratio. So we can consider any of the compounds. Say for example, here we consider water, H2. The formula of water is H2. H2O contains two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. That means water molecule is formed by the combination of two different elements, hydrogen and oxygen, in their fixed ratio. Here is the fixed ratio, 2:1. Two atoms for hydrogen and one atom for oxygen, 2:1. So we consider water from any source, whether it is well water, river water, pond water, tap water, rain water, any source of water can be taken. If the water is pure, then it must contain two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. If this ratio of hydrogen and oxygen gets varied, say for example, somewhere if we are getting the ratio of hydrogen and oxygen in a compound as 3:2, say for example, that means this is not water. Maybe some other compounds or may not be, but certainly it is not water. Because whenever we consider water as a pure substance, pure compound, it must contain the ratio of hydrogen and oxygen as 2:1. So this is called fixed ratio of the elements in a compound. Any example can be taken. Any more example like H2SO4. H2SO4 is a formula of sulfuric acid. You might have heard in earlier class also. Sulfuric acid. So sulfuric acid is represented by this formula H2SO4. Here, if we write the ratio for hydrogen, sulfur and oxygen, then hydrogen 2, sulfur 1 and oxygen 4 atoms. So this is 2:1:4. So if we consider sulfuric acid from any source, we have various methods for the preparation of sulfuric acid. But if it is pure sulfuric acid, pure compound. Our compound, you know, compound is always pure. Then it must contain two atoms of hydrogen, one atom of sulfur, and four atoms of oxygen. So this ratio is fixed in sulfuric acid. So in this way, we can consider any of the compound in nature, and all the compounds must contain elements in their fixed ratio. Now, another property of compound is it cannot be separated by physical means. That means physically the components of the compound or elements of the compound cannot be separated from each other. It may be separated, but it is by chemical method, not by physical method. So there is a question on it. Distinguish between an element and a compound. The question is quite clear. You can note it down. Distinguish between an element and a compound by giving at least 5 points. So here we have discussed compound in detail, and now we move on to mixture. Now, mixture is taken under impure substance. An impure substance is that substance which is made up of two or more different elements in their indefinite ratio. So the mixture is divided into two parts. We have already given in full chart, you know. Number one is homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture. Now, homogeneous mixture is that mixture in which components are well mixed throughout. So this is homogeneous mixture. Say for example, we consider the mixture of sugar and water, common salt and water. If sugar and water is taken as a mixture, and when with the help of a stirring, if it is well mixed, then any part of the mixture will give us the same sweetness. This is called homogeneity of the mixture, or the mixture is homogeneous mixture. So one identity of the homogeneous mixture is that it constitutes one phase. Say for example, here is a beaker or any glass tumbler containing water, and we add some sugar in it, and with the help of a stirrer we mix it. Here is a glass tumbler or a beaker. Here is water, and here is sugar. So this is after mixing it, we get the sweetness from any part of the mixture. This is called homogeneity of a mixture or homogeneous mixture. So this mixture will constitute one phase, single phase, and single phase, one phase means this is liquid phase.
So here
there is no such boundary between sugar and water because particles of sugar are well mixed in the particles of liquid. This constitute only one phase and here is liquid phase. Similarly, we can consider gaseous mixture. So if air is considered to be a mixture, this is also homogeneous mixture of several gases. We can't say here is oxygen, here is nitrogen or carbon dioxide present in air. They are not having separate boundary. So this also constitute one phase and this is gaseous phase. So this way we can understand homogeneity of a mixture or homogeneous mixture. So solution is taken under, the best example is solution. Solution is taken under homogeneous mixture. Now second one is heterogeneous mixture. Heterogeneous mixture. Now this heterogeneous mixture constitutes more than one phase and it is only possible when an insoluble substance is taken in water or any liquid unit. Say for example, if we consider a beaker containing some water and we add some sand particles to it. Now after mixing it with the help of a stirrer, and if it is kept for some time, then sand particles begin to settle down at the bottom of the container and we can easily see through naked eye two separate boundaries, one for sand particles and second one for liquid, that is for water. So this is heterogeneous mixture. That means whenever we consider a heterogeneous mixture, the components of the mixture are not mixed throughout, well mixed throughout. So this is heterogeneous mixture. So heterogeneous mixture is of two types. One is taken under colloid and other is suspension. So here is the sand particles in water. This is the example of suspension. This heterogeneous mixture, the components of heterogeneous mixture can be separated from each other by physical means. Here by tilting the beaker or container, we can separate water from sand particles. So this can be separated physically. Now under colloid is also heterogeneous mixture, but its properties lie in between solution and suspension. That means the particles of colloid or components of colloid partially soluble in other components, and the components of colloids are said to be dispersed phase and second one is dispersion medium. This is similar to the components of solution. We have already learned this is solute, which is in less amount, and this is solvent, which is in more amount. Similarly, a colloid or a colloidal solution has two components. One is dispersed phase, something like solute in a lesser amount, and dispersion medium and solvent which is in bigger amount. So we have lot of properties for colloid and suspension that I will discuss with you later on. Thank you.